It's still a mystery to me. That the hands of God could be so small. How tiny fingers reach in me.
On this holy night, heaven came down to earth. The love of God came down to us in the form of a priceless gift, God incarnate. The Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." They called his name Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Heaven came down, and God is now with us. The Bible says, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Heaven came down, and the Word is now here with us. Emmanuel, God is with us. The baby Jesus was born at night and not in the day. The light of the world came down to us in the midst of darkness. You see, light shines in the darkness, and darkness can never overcome it. On this holy night, there was a collision. Heaven invaded the earth. Light invaded darkness. God came down. Heaven's love reached down to save the world. A baby was born to save the souls of all mankind. The baby Jesus was heaven's perfect miracle, a free gift given to us from God in heaven above. God is now here with us, Emmanuel. But just before heaven invaded the earth and came down to us, God sent an angel to announce to shepherds the birth of the great shepherd of the sheep, saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to all men."
Who could have imagined this? Infant and the infinite, Son of God, so wonderful. Heaven's perfect miracle. Glory in the highest. Glory in the highest. Prince of peace, King of kings, Jesus, Lord of everything. Glory.
the highest heavens, they shouted, "Glory to God in the highest." The stars of the universe ignited in brilliant radiance, burning a trail in the heavens for the wise men to follow. It was a sign that heaven was coming down. The starry skies glowed, leading the Magi to the humble place where the King of Heaven was born. The Bible says that he was born king, but he always was king of his people Israel. For centuries, the shout of the king was among them on the battlefields. The shout of the invisible king was among them that sent terror into the hearts of their enemies. This invisible king ruled and reigned over them for centuries until the day that they rejected him as their king. In their rebellion, they chose a man to become their king. "You have rejected me as your king," announced God through the mouth of his prophet Samuel. The star led the wise men to the small town of Bethlehem. Bethlehem means house of bread. The bread of life came down from heaven and was delivered to the house of bread for all mankind to eat. Jesus himself said, "I am the living bread that came down from heaven." They gave the baby Jesus gifts of gold, myrrh, and frankincense. They acknowledged that he was the Prince of Peace, the King of Kings, and Jesus Christ, Lord of everything. Who knew that God and sinners would be reconciled when heaven came down? Who knew that God would be born in a humble stable with animals? Who knew that the Lamb of God would be born among little lambs? Who knew that he was born to die and born to save the world? Who knew that he was born to take our sin away? His mother knew. Mary knew in her heart. And like all mothers do, she knew.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you
sight to a blind man. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kissed your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh Mary, did you know? The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The praise is of the Lamb. is Lord of all creation. Did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the great
Who knew that he would one day walk on water? This Jesus of Nazareth that was born in a stable in Bethlehem. Who knew that he would one day spit on the ground and rub mud into a man's eyes, causing the blind to see? Go and wash, he said, and the man's eyes were opened. Who knew that he would one day speak to the wind and the waves, and they would obey him? Peace, be still, he said, and the wind and the waves obeyed. Who knew that he would one day walk on water? Who knew? Who knew that he would cause the deaf to hear, the dumb to speak, and the dead to be brought back to life again? Who knew that he would one day die upon a cruel cross as King of the Jews? It is finished, he said, and it was paid in full. Who knew that he would one day be exalted to the highest place and be given a name that is above every other name, Jesus Christ, King of Kings and Lord of Lords? Who knew that he would rule over the nations and our invisible King seated at the right hand of God? Who knew? Who knew that heaven would invade earth on that starry night? Heaven came down. He is now here with us. Who knew that God would one day be with man? Who knew that one day he would come and make the hearts of men his dwelling place? He said, me and my Father will come and make our home in your heart. Who knew? Who knew that heaven would come down and dwell in the hearts of men and women? Who knew? God is still with us today, living in our hearts, because of the priceless gift that he gave on the day when heaven came down. He is indeed here with us. God is with us, Emmanuel. He is indeed Jesus the Christ, Lord of everything.
Come, let us adore him in this place today.